Monday was the 25th anniversary of National Indigenous Peoples Day in Canada, although this year, it's a time of sorrow. Indigenous people are using the marked day to mourn the remains of 215 children's bodies at a residential school in Kamloops, BC.
It's a really huge day for not only me. I'm doing this for my grandparents who were residential school survivors. I'm doing it for my son and his future family as well, and for everybody else who is here.
Trista Cook, who's lived in Lloydminster for 12 years now, says she's now experiencing more respect than ever from other residents.
You go around and people actually acknowledge you as a First Nation, because like I would go around and people would never look me in the eye, and I don't know why, but now recently my shoulders are more up and I'm walking around and people actually look at me and say hello and even let me go ahead of them in lines, and I was pretty surprised about that too.
She believes some people are more proud and are learning not to be ashamed of being Indigenous anymore.
Like today, like I'm so proud to be First Nations, and before when I was young, like I hate to say it, but I was ashamed. Like I used to wish I was a different color because we got treated differently. And now I feel like I can walk around proud of who I am and people respect me.
A couple residential school survivors also spoke at City Hall, along with Métis dancers that performed for everybody. The hope after Indigenous Day is for others to give the respect to First Nations people that they deserve, and that Indigenous people should be proud of the color of their skin.
They were grabbed from their families. Imagine how they felt without their parents, without their guardians. Some didn't even make it home.
This is our land, and we share it with everybody, and it just doesn't feel nice when you walk around in public and people look down on you. So now I feel like we can walk around and be proud, and we should be. We should be proud Indigenous people.
For Primetime Local News, I'm Shelby Clark.